Angling Bait Company, River Wye Winter League. The name I mentioned there, Angling Bait Company, are kindly our sponsors again for this year. Please give them what they deserve in return by mentioning them at every opportunity during this week. Okay, we're very lucky to have it. It enables us to pay extra money for the team payout and just adds to the league. On that note, I did raise the team entry for the league this year by £30, I think it was total, whatever. That will enable us then to pay a fourth place in the league. I'm not going to put it onto the winners thing. I'm going to bring more people into, more teams into contention for more money. That keeps the interest going to the end of the league. So that was the reason for that, in case anyone was wondering that. There's a couple of things I ask of you as anglers of teams. You've got a team captain. You need to help those team captains. Okay, there is nothing worse and someone letting you down last minute, trying to get people in, what have you. I know things happen, but it does happen regularly. And the way we brought in this new payout structure last year that Dave designed, and it's brilliant. And nothing can interrupt that. So every match, the team, if you enter a team, it has to pay the full pool's money. So if you drop out last minute, whether it be for a genuine reason or just because you don't fancy the cold or something like that, you've got to expect that you will have to pay your pools at some point. People shouldn't be out of pocket. Okay, so help your team captains by giving them the notice, giving them of anything that might be coming up, and so you're not causing a problem for them.
We got a chance for Barb on it.
Okay, good morning, guys. You just heard Dave Robertson, start of the first of the winter leagues on the River Wye at Belmont, Hedeford. The river is actually almost bank high. It's at least 2 metres above normal level. Now, years ago, we used to fish a lot of winter leagues here, and we'd fish it in these sort of conditions. Predominantly mainly bleak. There's the odd fish to be caught as well, but it's very, very coloured, very, very chocolate. And perhaps it's a little bit of a leveller, but also it gives the better teams an advantage, because the teams like Hereford and Cadence, and even Dave Howell's lot now, MAP, Midland Anglers, they got a very strong team. So as a nomads, there's us Cotswold Wizards are all on like equal sort of footing, if you like. They are going to pay fourth overall in the team over the season, so that's our goal, getting the top four. We shall see. Right, I've drawn peg 41, which is normally quite a good area for Barbo, whether they'll go today, I'm not sure, but as a team match, I will be looking at bleak as a predominant target to fish. So anyway, no further to do, all the guys are just arriving in the van, so getting ready to go. I'm nearly ready. Yeah, just all untripping their gear. Some are walking up, some walking down. Yeah, all pulling up there. So let's get down to the peg and let's show you what I got to do today. Okay, peg 41. It's the old ferry peg. See the steps opposite? I think I mentioned this on my last vlog years ago. It was a flyer. Because not so used, not so good. But it's an area that I got nice slack. And I just put my platform down there. So, say bleak will be the main target. I will have a plunk out for, for a barbel maybe, I don't know. Maybe perch. Let's have a suck and see on this match. When it's like this, it's difficult to know what to do. Obviously, if the bleak are there, then that's the main thing. For the team, otherwise it is known for barbel.
Five.
All right, mate, where you go?
43.
Okay,
What's that, 41?
41, yeah. The old ferry peg.
Oh, of course,
yeah. Yeah, yeah. If I remember, there's some stick-ups there. Not stick-ups, but an old reminiscent old platform.
Yeah, there's two.
Yeah. I can't see them at the moment, but I remember just in the water there is... Oh, I've just seen a bleak come up then. Yeah. But there are a couple of what they call scaffolding from an old platform under the water, so that might be a problem. But there, I see the bleak, a couple of bleak topping, so I'll be setting my whips up. Definitely. So I might put a feeder out. And I might, I don't know if I'm going to put a bolly up, I don't know. I think it's a matter of maybe concentrating just on bleak. For the team. It's for the team anyway. Okay. Right, let's tackle up. Okay, right. Just having a chat with a couple of the boys. I think everybody's going to do the same as me by the sound of it. Go for bleak. But one or two said they'll have a look at barrel first. So, right, my tactic has always been to go for dace and roach to begin with, and then when the bleak move in, then obviously switch to bleak. So anyway, that's what I've done. That's what I'm going to do, I think. Probably start off with a feeder, or even a flat float. We'll see what happens anyway. It is dropping. It's dropped 2 inches already, so it's coming down quite well. Right, I'm going to show you my mixes and that. Right, this is my... I'm going to boil in some of my barbel special. This is garlic and fish meal. Okay, then I've got my special bleak yellow mix, which is turmeric, spices, red maggots, of course, castor. I got castor as well. I put a couple of pints in there, but I got a couple of pints of castors, kilo worms, gallon of maggots, and that's it. There's my whips. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 whips set up, feeder, and a long flat float. So, yeah. I've got another rod set. I was just about to set up a bolly, but to be honest, I don't think that's... it's just a bit too high for a bolly at the moment. Yeah, I'll probably curse myself afterwards if it does drop even lower. But anyway, what I've done, I've also converted a big net to go into my keep net for the bleak. So I'll raise this up a little bit. So. Obviously, if any bleak drop off the hook, they'll go into the net quick. Set up another net there, just in case there's any fall on the side. And that's it, really. Okay, so just waiting for the haul in now, which is in about 5 minutes. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, short and sweet this video because all I've done is catch bleak. I started off okay for the first 2 hours, 3 hours, and then it started going pear-shaped. Then the water dropped by about 2 foot, and the boils in the swim got worse, and the bleak just scattered. Apparently, a few people along here said the same. They were catching bleak and then they disappeared. On the other hand, Tom Bolton, who's only about 2 pegs up, he didn't catch bleak to begin with, so he's chucked up in the middle and he's had 11 barbel. You just never know with this place. He's admitting to about 40 pound. If the bleak would have kept coming, I would have been up there as well. But anyway, I counted 700 and then that was it. And then just a few at the end, just dribs and drabs of them. Yeah, mate, I fish for the team, that's the thing, at the end of the day. So, let's see, just waiting for the weigh, Let's see what happens. let's see how I fared in the section. Okay, see you in a bit. Okay, 28 pounds of best so far. Just weighing in Tom now. He's admitting to 40, so let's have a look.
Get one.
50 pound 6. He said he underestimates. Yeah, you did, didn't you? Nice one, Tom.
Yeah, I got it.
There you go, 24.8. As I say, it's a shame that they just died to death after about 3 hours. Same for everyone. Right, there's a 50 pound, 28, I think I'm third in the section. I'll just double check that anyway. So it's not too bad, Coming to the top three in your section is a good achievement with this. With these standards of anglers. Should retire, shouldn't I? Right, let's go back and see the results. Thank you. Thanks for watching, boys.
First with 46 pound 4 ounces was Phil Amos.
Amos. Yeah. Bleak. Peg 10.
Second with 26 pound 6 was Dave Feeney. And winning the match on the day with 50 pound 6 ounces was Tom Bolton.
Have that.
Second with 28 pound 2 was Joe Holloway.
Well done, Joe.
Third with
25
pounds
was
Tom Hobbs.
Come on, dummy by a pound.
C section first with 34 pound 8 ounces finishing in what place?
The 6 in with a few defaults.
All right, so this is taking 6 for the overall as well, with the option as well. 34 pound 8 was Lee Edwards.
Oh, there he is. No, you done it, eh?
second with 26 pounds dead was Nigel Evans.
Good day. Go home, go check his prospect. That's the money.
Third with 23 back 14 was Spud Murphy.
That's bad.
D section first with 42 pound 12 was Jeff Briley.
Jeff.
Second with £33.10 was Rory Jones. Third with £27.08 was Chris Hallows. E section, first with £49 dead and finishing second overall today was Brian Rickley.
Well, Riggers.
Second with 41 pounds 8 ounces and finishing third overall was Matt Derry.
Well, Matt.
Third with 39 pound 8 ounces and
fourth in the Super Bowl.
Come on,
small Brill Cream Mark.
Come on.
F section first with 34 pound 6 ounces and last in the Super Bowl was Dave Wallace.
Well, Dave.
Second with £30 12 ounces was Kev Ellaby.
Well, Kev,
no, I think.
And third with £26 11 was Damien Scriven. That's gone. That's gone. We must take it, Damien. For a long time. Okay, teams on the day. Right, so 12th place with 19 points was Alan. 11th with 27 was Stories. 10th with 29 was ABC. And we've got a joint seventh, three teams on 33 points was Ludlow Wizards and Nomad B. Sixth with 36 points was Woody's Bake Tech. Fifth with 48 points was Cadence. Fourth with 50 points was Nomad A. Third with 52 points was DH Anglin. Second, they're back with 53 points was Cotswolds. And your winners on the day with 56 points was Woody's.
Well, 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 well.